Hey guys, one go show up play. It's Mike here playing a Battle Squad for the Sega Mega Drive. Battle Squad. Oh! Well, that's what the file name said. I know this one all too well. This is Battle Squadron. Battle Squad. What was I thinking? Battle Squad. Why didn't I see that was clearly going to be Battle Squad? Why didn't I go? Battle Squad. Where's Battle Squadron? I'm going to be rubbish at this now I've said that. Hey, these guys are coming home from a mission against the Barracks Empire and they've just been kidnapped. We'd better save them. There you go, getting kidnapped. Smiling about it. Alright, one player it is. Awesome two-player game. I think I've always been rubbish at it. Oops, wrong button. Yep, that says it all. Okay, it's one of those ones you can't hold the fire button. You've got to tap that bad boy. That can get quite tiring, but it's kind of also one of the things that makes a top-down or side-scrolling schmuck kind of cool. I never employed it. I employed a system in my little smoke, which was kind of cool. Cooler still, I would argue, which is, you don't have to tap the button. You can hold it down, but you also get a bonus point for every frame of the game that you are not pressing the fire button, so it actually pays to only shoot when you need to. Oh, that's harsh. Oh, that's harsh. Wanted that because I know that that contains power up, and let's face it, this is a pea shooter. As we just saw, oh, that guy was like surrounded by his mates. I reckon one on one out of that game. Right. Good game, balanced bullet speed. Just really need to get a power up now because it's not going to get any easier. there's one. You know what? I'm having him. Wow, that took a while, didn't it? Alright, now we're talking. Now we've got a chance. And I'm about to power up behind, though, of course, don't forget. Because I lost the first one. Which really, really sucks. Now, while this game is not an easy game, it is a dang awesome game. I mean, it is awesome. It's not my genre, to be fair. I don't really generally like shmups that much. Because, you know, they all fit the formula. And let's face it, we know the formula. Hey! Far too well. That was a bit cheeky. But what's cool about this is it kind of breaks some of the more rubbishy rules. Like, you do not lose your power-up when you lose a life. That is a good rule. Everyone should... Oh, that was silly. That was me being rubbish. Let's give it another crack. I think we might get a continue if we're lucky. Oh, we don't... Still, hang on, can we get continues in the options? Not that I'm gonna. I just want to know. Credits per player, you can. So you can go up to 3. Number of lives, 3. You can go up to 5. Max any bullets. Ooh, nasty. So we were on the hardest there. Any bullet speed? Whoa. No way. See, I like a game that has slow bullets, but lots of them. And as we're having one go, we'll just stick with that. But I want to play it again. In fact, no. No, we will. I was tempted to put more credits in, but we are... Oh, I've done it again. But we are already up to 3 minutes. Man... Right, let's play this game like we mean it. We're going to get that first power up. Dagnabbit. We're going to get that first power up. I said that like that dude out of Predator. Says there, I'm going to have me some fun. Just before he dies. Which is probably what we're going to do. Now see how slow those bullets move in. It doesn't actually make them any easier. Because now they're hanging around on screen. Oh man, okay. No, if anything, this makes things harder. Because our bullet hell has just become a static bullet hell. With... Oh, I've got to use that again because I can't get in front of him. With lots and lots of bullets. I think if you shoot those power-ups, they change colour and you get different ones. Like, this is kind of cool. But we're still on, like, power level 1 and we could do a beam on this power level 2. What have I done to myself putting these bullets on slow? I was totally wrong about that. This game is not balanced for such slow bullets. Have to remember that. But yeah, this was also on the Amiga, and I think it was pretty much identical, except, as was often the case with the Amiga, although the system had, the Amiga had loads of... stealth. Oh, I see, it changes colour. That's massive. Yeah, although the Amiga had loads of really rubbishy titles, basically because of the PD market, which in itself wasn't a bad thing. It also had capabilities that the Mega Drive didn't. Now, while this version sounds really good, to my memory, I think the Amiga version actually sounds much better. Basically, because they use samples instead of iTunes. That's basically it. And we can make it sound however we want it. It was an advantage of the Amiga, and some would say an unfair advantage. But it is what it is, and it's what made the Amiga what it was. So, you know, the Amiga version was pretty much identical. It probably played a little bit differently. It probably had quite different sound. But on both systems, Battle Squadron, really hard game, really awesome game. Thank you very much.